We thought NASA was a bunch of really elite scientists, and what they were doing was just like another world from what we were doing. But the experience of working with NASA data, with scientists at NASA, really taught us about how we as kids can contribute.
In early August, a new app became available on the iOS App Store. Called Dust Watch, it warns users of early dust storm conditions and helps them prepare for the potentially hazardous weather events. The app uses National Weather Service forecasts improved by NASA data and was built by four Maryland high schoolers who wanted to help people affected by the storms.
So as a group of friends, we hang out a lot, and one day at the pool, I think, we're discussing about the harmful effects of dust storms because we watched a really jarring documentary in school. We were talking about it and we were like, wow, we need to learn more. So I hopped on the internet and I learned more about dust storms, and we were like, wow, this is so bad.
We would have meetings maybe once a week, 2 to 3 hours. We're in high school, so we have a lot of tests and stuff, right? So we wouldn't have a lot of time to do that. When we had like breaks and stuff, we would take advantage of the extra time and just have more than one meeting.
After they decided to create the Dust Watch app, the group realized they needed some help. A family friend introduced them to the National Weather Service database they could use to forecast storm conditions. Then, Bill met a software engineer who agreed to mentor them in programming. They built the app around their already busy high school schedules.
Our app pulls data from a web service on a regular basis, so it periodically does calculations for most cities in the U.S. that can find what levels of certain air quality conditions there are in that region, and then the user can search that up for a forecast, or they could also have it periodically checked in the app by the background and receive push notifications.
So it pretty much just tracks all like the harmful metrics of dust storms, right? So dust concentration, visibility, wind speed, and PM2.5, which are pretty much what cause damages and injuries.
The team presented their app to scientists with NASA's Applied Science Program.
My favorite part was attending the HACAS meeting, which is NASA's Health and Air Quality Applied Science Team meeting. And we got to present our app, we met a lot of people, and we got valuable feedback on our project. Honestly, I think when we all started making this app, none of us probably thought it was even going to be that like possible, because we had zero programming knowledge at all, and it was just like an idea we threw out there, and it was like, maybe we could try this, and it was like, in the end, we accomplished it. It just felt rewarding and like relieving to finally have the app up on the App Store.